My career started with gold teeth and ended with this gold jacket. Good night and God bless.
Immokalee High School alum Edgerrin James stole the show over the weekend with his acceptance speech into the NFL Hall of Fame.
Oh, I had chills listening to him. An honor made possible in part because of its roots in Southwest Florida. NBC2's Derek Kopp is in the studio after speaking to Edge's former coaches.
Yeah, it was a magical moment. Now, to get to this stage over the weekend, Edgerrin James became a legend with the Indianapolis Colts. Before that, he was a Hall of Famer with the Miami Hurricanes. But all those roads, they lead back to Immokalee High School and this field, where James began to write his story his way. As Edgerrin James took the stage and admired his Hall of Fame bust, he took the time to reflect on the beginning.
For me, it all started in Immokalee, Florida. Immokalee High School is where I made a name for myself in football and where I became a man at a young age.
James starred for the Indians in the early 90s.
Good job, good job, let's go.
Catching the eye of a young running backs coach right away.
I knew him coming from Pop Warner to expect him, but when he stepped on the field, again, he was like a man amongst boys.
Trust me, I know.
Tim Howell was James's position coach and saw a fire in Edge's eyes at an early age, and not just because of football, but because of family.
He kind of put a lot of pressure on himself to do well in school and then in football because he knew that was going to be his future.
The drive he had led to an all-out commitment, even sleeping at Coach Howell's home to make sure he would make practice. And in the offseason...
I know that Edgerrin, you know, he spent a lot of time in the offseason, right? We do offseason workouts. He would be gone because he'd travel up north to pitch watermelons.
That determination translated to one of the best high school, college, and pro football careers in history.
You know, Edgerrin's, best football player, obviously, that came out of Immokalee High School.
But the lesson here is how he did it.
When he comes to Immokalee, if we're practicing, he always comes out here and talks to the kid. And he can say, I was the best, and to get to that, you need to work hard.
If you need any other evidence, you can find it in Canton, Ohio.
He always said that he wanted to be part of being the greatest. Well, Edgerrin, you are one of the greatest. And you're number 336 in the Hall of Fame.
Now, Coach Howell was invited by Edgerrin, as you saw, to the Hall of Fame ceremony over the weekend and said it was the best experience he's had as a family friend and coach. And I've got a feeling that party, it's still continuing in Immokalee. But as you guys said, just had chills during that speech.
Yeah, you could tell his coach was all choked up.
He got two standing ovations in like an 8-minute speech. I Google Edgerrin James Hall of Fame speech.
It's worth it.
Make your kids watch it. It was so good.
Messages throughout, and as we said at the top, I love the gold teeth, the gold jacket. People wanted him to change, and that bust with the dreadlocks, it was a perfect weekend. So much fun.
Congratulations to him.